Welcome back, everyone, and welcome to another video. And in this video, we are going to learn how to make this 3D printable tray within Fusion 360. With that said, let's get started. All right, so to get started with our design, the first thing we could do is to create a new component. Let's go ahead and hover over to create, new component, and let's go ahead and name this to basic tray. From here, let's go ahead and create a sketch by clicking on create, create sketch, select the bottom plane. And then what we're gonna do is use the center rectangle from the origin, drag this out. And the dimensions I'm gonna set for this design, it is gonna be 70 in terms of the length. And the width of this is gonna be about 50. So that way we have more of a rectangular look rather than a square, but you can of course change that later on if you like, but feel free to use the size that it fits most to you. So in this case, I'm working with 70 by 50, pressing E on my keyboard, select the top profile. And now what we're gonna do is drag this up to around, let's just say 30 millimeters. In this case, we have basically what is a basic rectangle within our canvas. And now we can go ahead and setting up some features for this. So by pressing O, select the top face, select the edge, and drag this into about -2 millimeters. From here, what we want to do is press E on our keyboard, select the profile here, drag this into about -2, and press OK. Make sure the operation is set to cut, because that way we are going to cut into the rectangle itself. Once more, pressing O, select the top face, drag this into about -2 millimeters, press Enter, selecting the top, pressing E, and go ahead and drag this down to meet all the way towards the bottom. Now, somewhere around 25 to 30, it cuts right through. So I would say anywhere from -28, -27. So -27 is where it meets right before it cuts right into it. So I'd say 26.5 just for good measure, and press OK. Now that we have this, we have a basic rectangle with some cutouts made for our design. So what we can do now is by using some features within Fusion, let's go ahead and add some chamfers to these inner edges here. Pressing S, type in chamfer, select each and every single corner of this design. And all we're doing is just adding some chamfers just for good measure. Now that we have that, let's go ahead and shell the exterior of this design to add some more features. So by pressing S, type in shell, select all four faces of this design. Now be careful not to select any of the inside faces because it's very easy to do so. And make sure to have that numeric count that you have here. So you see I have 4 selected. Change the inside thickness to 1.75. And letting that load. There it is. We have the basic tray made within Fusion 360. So what we're going to do now is by using this design, we're going to go ahead and create some basic features here on the bottom. So that way we can mirror this all the way around our entire design. So by creating a new sketch, select the bottom plane or the bottom face. Let's go ahead and draw this out. So when it comes to creating some sketches, in order to make this easier for us, what we can actually do is create a 2-point rectangle. And using these 2-point rectangles, all we're gonna do is just create some on each corner. So we're gonna create one on the right-hand side and 2 on the left-hand side. And make sure that your rectangle is snapping onto your pieces here, and you'll kind of feel it snap on as there is some friction or like a stopping point where the mouse kind of stops. You can kind of see it with the little icon. From here, let's go ahead and set up some dimensions for this right-hand side. Let's set this to around 1.2 millimeters. And the reason why is because that's gonna be just enough of a thickness when we 3D print it. So it's not gonna break really easily, but it's also not too thick. So that's very important. So let's also dimension from here to here, and we can set this to around 5 millimeters. Now that we have that, let's go ahead and dimension the left-hand side, and we can use the existing dimensions that we have on this sketch to reference that. Doing the exact same thing for this side here, selecting the 5, and that's gonna reference the 5 here, and press okay. Doing the exact same thing for this side, selecting the 5, press okay. Selecting from edge to edge, 1.2, press OK. Now, the reason why we're doing this is because if we were to ever change this to like 5, that means everything else would also adjust accordingly. So instead of having to manually redo every single one and having to take a bit more time to do it, if you were to ever change it, you can just rechange one and everything else will reflect that thereafter. So from here, pressing E on our keyboard, select the top faces here, or the profiles, and drag this up to the top. Now that we have this basic design made here. So what I'm also gonna do is just actually drag it to here. That's where it meets the top face here. Change the operation to join, so that way we have these bars sitting in here, and press OK. Now that we have that, what we need to do here is to mirror this onto the other side. Now for some people, if this was more of a square than a rectangle, some people might use circular pattern for that to revolve these features all around it. And while technically that could work, this would not work with more of a rectangular look. So for example, if you're trying to use parametric modeling for a design like this, you need to make sure you're using the right features in this, which in this case is going to be the mirror feature, in order to make sure that we have all the features mirrored to the right or to the left-hand side and as well as on the back. So that way, if you ever decide to resize this, you're not going to see any sort of issues. So for example, let me show you what I mean. So in this case, we're going to press S on our keyboard, type in mirror. And then what we want to do is change the object type to features. And what we're going to do is select the last feature within our timeline, which is the three bars we created, selecting the mirror plane. And the mirror plane is going to be located within the origin, which we're going to use the one in the middle here. And now what we have is basically an outline of what we have on the right hand side being mirrored to the left hand side. So if we press OK, now we have this on the other side as well, which is really cool because that's what we're looking for. What we can also do is press mirror once again. So typing in S, type in mirror, and we can actually use the extrude feature and the mirror feature. So we're basically mirroring a mirror, and we can use that to mirror that to the other side as well. So by pressing enter, now we basically mirrored an extrude and mirrored a mirror. So I know it's a handful, but that's basically what we've done. And in this case, if I ever were to resize this, so let's just say if I go back to sketch one and maybe for whatever reason I change it to 90, you'll always see that it's going to basically kind of remain parametric, which is very important. So going back here, I have our design. Pretty cool. So from here, what we can also do to finish this up is to add some sort of chamfer here. So in this case, you can see there's like a part here. And if we were to 3D print this, it could be an issue and we might need supports. And in this case, we don't want to use supports for this. So what we can do is just press S, type in chamfer, and we can either chamfer these edges here. And just to show you what that looks like, 1.25, let's see if 1.3 does the trick, 1.4, 1.25 does the trick. And what you want to do is just go all around this design and just chamfer it. That way you get a nice clean edge here that doesn't rely on supports. And from here, there you go. Additionally, let's also double check to make sure everything's in order. So if I were to resize this design, and let's just say if I were to resize the heights of the design, so maybe from a 30 to maybe a 27.5, maybe a little bit smaller, you can see that we're finding some issues. And the issue relies on the fact that we did not set the extrude for these bars to a 2 option. So if we go back in our timeline, and all I'm doing is just showing you some things that could go wrong in case you do change it later on. So instead of having the extend type to distance, we'd have it to 2 object. So we would select the top face here. And as you can see, it's being selected all the way to the top, which is actually going to be here instead. Press join. Now we basically have, if we were to resize it in terms of the height, going back to 30, it's going to adjust accordingly, which is perfect because that's exactly what you need to do if you're going to use parametric modeling. So now that we have this done, what we can also do here is just finish this up because we basically have our basic tray here. So in order to create that kind of cool opening here in the middle, so we can create a cutout here. Let's go ahead and create a sketch at the top. And what we're gonna do is just create a piece from here to here. And I'm just gonna drag it out. It doesn't have to be perfect. We're gonna go ahead and dimension this from side to side. Let's say 10 is fine. And from here to here, 10 as well is fine as well. And there you go. Selecting this profile that we've made, pressing E, drag this down. and you can drag it down however far you'd want. So I'd say negative 20 works just fine. And now we have this kind of simple opening slot. So like if you would want to put stuff inside, you can absolutely do so. Additionally, what I'm also going to do is to chamfer this inner edge here. Chamfer this all the way to the very top, so it looks kind of cooler. And also add another chamfer, selecting this edge and this edge. And there you go. So now we have three chamfers. So it's going to be a new selection set. For some reason, didn't select. Chamfer this up, creating another selection set. It's going to be this edge here. And this one's going to be all the way to, you can go as high as you'd want. Doesn't really matter. And you can kind of see kind of like how we can play around with this a little bit more, make it a little bit more unique, add some more features to this. So if I were to add another selection set, we can probably add one here. Let's see what that looks like. And now we kind of have this like cool effect here. So it looks more industrial, kind of like a minimal crate. And we can also set this one here to like an angle. So I'm just basically going off on a tangent right now on the type of edges that we can use, but I'm just showing you guys some options so you guys can play around with it and have fun with it. You can see we're at a 70 degree angle. Let's see, 65 works fine. And now we have this chamfered here. You have this chamfer down here, and you have a little bit of chamfer here to put stuff inside. So that way it doesn't like kind of sit in this corner here, which does become an issue when you put stuff inside. So there is our final design. Now there are some things that we could do better in terms of making this more parametric, in terms of just avoiding if we were to resize this and having to go back within our timeline. But that's the basic look of our design. Hopefully this video has been insightful and informative. And let's go ahead and add some color to this. So let's just say we add a yellow color, and let's add this to a matte yellow. Let's go ahead and render this. And there you have it. There you have a basic organizer tray for your items. You can, of course, use parametric modeling, which would be an entirely different video. I'm only showing you guys that because I know some of you may want to resize this, but that is the general look of this. In addition to this, this doesn't require any supports. You would just go around, make sure that everything has at least some sort of chamfer or tapered angle, so that way you don't have to use supports for this. But with that said, thank you guys so much for watching. What I'm gonna do is go ahead and print this out, kind of show you what it looks like, and let's see what the final results are. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay, so here is the final look of the design. Here we have three different sizes, small, medium, and large, and I had resized them with Infusion. Now keep in mind, you can use parametric modeling to avoid having to change things within our timeline, but to make this video simple and not too complicated, we're gonna go ahead and skip that and leave that for another video. But I think the end result of the prints came out really well. I printed it in this yellow color, and as well as the layer height I used for this is about 0.112, so it is a little bit smaller in terms of layer height, but I think the quality and the look of it came out absolutely great. So if you guys want to get access to the STL files for this project, make sure to join the Fusion 360 group for 3D printing down below in the description. We have over 1,000 members learning Fusion 360 and mastering their skills around 3D printing. So I'd love to have you if you want to get access to the STLs and to more bonus resources. If you guys enjoyed today's tutorial and you want to see more advanced content around 3D printing, Fusion 360, and maybe even selling your own digital designs or physical prints, check out the School of 3D Printing down below in the description. It's an online community teaching you exactly how to design your own products from scratch, teaching you everything from snap fit joints to designing toolboxes to designing planters to hinges, parametric modeling, moving mechanisms, storage crates, lamps, neon signs, and honestly, so much more. It's an online community that I'm launching on July 1st. So if you're interested in joining that community and getting access to more advanced tutorials and resources, check out the link down below, join the waitlist, and once it launches, you'll be first to be notified as soon as it launches for that program. But with that said, thank you guys so much for watching. Subscribe to the channel and like the video if you liked it. See you guys in the next video. Take care.